Hey Fist Friends, how's it going? Hope you're doing well. My name is Zenzo with Tozawa Tanks. So as many of you know, I'm big into freshwater tanks. I've got 35 aquariums here in our home. Most of them are downstairs in a fish room. I do have 5 tanks upstairs. But this is my only saltwater tank. Everything else is freshwater, with the exception of my brackish tank downstairs. So about 3 months ago, I decided to convert this little 5-gallon tank from a freshwater betta tank to a little nano reef tank. I've always been interested in reef tanks. I've never kept any reef fish or any corals or anything. So I kind of approached it as a complete beginner and novice to the hobby. So after the initial cycle phase and making sure that all the water parameters are correct, I went down to one of the fish stores in the area that specializes in corals and did a little shopping. I got a hermit crab, I got a couple of coral frags, and I do have an update for you guys. So the first thing I want to share is the orange Ricordia is doing fantastic. It was really kind of blossoming and growing larger when I first got it. After a couple of weeks, I got a snail for this aquarium as I had a little bit of algae buildup. And then I noticed that the Ricordia was kind of smaller in size. Part of it was kind of cut back. So I started to worry. But then keeping a close eye on it, I saw that the Ricordia was growing back, so I didn't have any issues. In fact, it is very healthy. When I put brine shrimp in there, it will actually like wrap itself around the brine shrimp and eat the brine shrimp, so that's pretty cool. The other coral that I got was, I got a little green candy cane, and that one hasn't fared as well. I did have it originally placed on the dry rock, and it was growing beautifully, was big and bulbous and green, and then what I noticed is the snail that I put in there was irritating the coral. So I don't know if the snail was kind of attacking the coral or what, you know, I'm a complete novice to this, so I really don't know kind of how that works. But what I noticed is that after being bothered by the snail, the coral started to kind of die back. Eventually, it kind of got to a point where I don't know if it's going to recover. It doesn't look well. I did move it down a little bit lower, just trying to try a couple of different things to see if, you know, maybe it was getting too much flow or maybe too much light. I don't know, but I did move it down here to the bottom of the tank. There is still a little bit of green on there, so part of the colony might be alive, but it doesn't look very promising for that one. If you guys have any comments, if you have any suggestions on what I might do for that coral as a beginner to keeping coral and reef tanks, then please let me know in the comments down below. So since that candy cane was kind of dying back, I decided to add some other corals. I went to a different fish store, and they just had a bunch of different coral frags that were really inexpensive. They were like $9.99 a piece or something like that, or $7.99, I don't remember. So anyway, I grabbed a couple that I thought looked really cool and placed those in the tank, and those are doing very well. I also got a fish. Now I know this is a 5-gallon system, and really, you know, it's pretty small to have any fish. I was just gonna do invertebrates. I do have the hermit crab in there. I have a camel shrimp, and I have that snail that I'm gonna keep for now, but maybe I shouldn't have a snail. I don't know. You guys can let me know in the comments below. But anyway, I decided I wanted to get a fish just because, you know, I'm a fish guy, it's a fish tank, and I didn't wanna just have a tank with invertebrates in it. So I got a little firefish. Now, originally I wanted to do like an anemone and a like a clown or a pair of clowns that would host in the anemone, but after doing a lot of research and reading your comments, I decided that this tank is really too small for any clowns. You know, maybe a really experienced reefer can do it, but me, I decided to not go that direction and not do any anemones just because they can get quite large. And I think I'm gonna shy away from the clownfish for this tank. Down the road, maybe I'll get like a 10 or 15 gallon nano tank, and I might do clowns at that time. But for the time being, I'm just gonna stick with just some small corals and the little firefish. That firefish is really cool, really beautiful, very unique. It is kind of shy though. It has found kind of a little home at the base of the dry rock. There's a kind of a cave, and it kind of goes in there. It is, I believe, part of the goby family, so it does kind of have those goby characteristics. But when I do put brine shrimp in the tank, it definitely comes out regardless of whether I'm close by or not, swims around, darts around, and eats the brine shrimp. So that's it for now. you know, the water has been doing well as far as the water parameters. I have been doing water changes on a weekly basis, and I've been doing about 30% water change. So, you know, again, this is 5 gallons, so it's not a whole lot of salt water that I'm having to make and change for this tank. But besides that one hiccup with the little candy cane, everything else is doing well. I do have a friend that lives not too far from me that is big into reef tanks, and he has offered to give me some corals for free as well. He's got some stuff that he's just got overgrowing, and he's gonna let me come get them and put them in here. So anyway, that's all for now. I just wanted to share with you guys an update on the saltwater tank, the reef tank. Get some advice from some of you experienced reefers to tell me what I'm doing wrong with that candy cane. Is it something that I could have avoided? Should I not have put a snail in there? But I kind of wanted to have a natural way of combating some of the algae. And I don't mind a little bit of algae. I can remove that myself with a scraper. But just like on the rock and everything, it did do a very good job of cleaning up the algae. So anyway, thanks for watching. I do appreciate all the likes. It does help my channel. I do appreciate all the comments. I try to read and respond to everyone. I don't always get to it because there's a lot of you that have things to say, but I try to get to most of you guys. Anyway, thanks for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.